You have started again today. What is the matter?
No, no, it is the same complaint that every week the people of Okuba are not dispossessed of here.
Yes.
What did you say? You're being dispossessed?
Yes.
What's this? My father never told me that Asumino was at any time the land of slaves.
What actually happened?
Imagine today. My household went to the market with loads of goods, pot and pot of oil, basket of kernel, eggs, two fat trunk, 10 cups, 5 pence, heap of plantains and bananas. Come and see. Only this one.
Now that the sun shines
mind of pursuing it. Instead of managing our stress for the great part of our head, we are here behaving like little children who let them put the water on their belly.
Omona, please, I have pressing family matters to attend to. So, whatever we are to discuss, let's hurry up. Tell us.
Again, you have started again.
Again, what will be more important than what you have gathered here to discuss?
Didn't you see the crowd in my compound? My in-laws are still negotiating. They want to live with my daughter.
You shouldn't have been here in the first place.
Does this mean that we mothers don't have pressing family matters to attend? Even if you don't have daughters to give what in marriage to the mother, at least we have both. We must sell our good price. Our freedom and dignity to say that.
But tell me, how many times have we assembled in the past to take decisions that were never carried out? Woman, when King Jaja rejected our demand, what did we do?
By the way, what can we do?
But we should remember that it was at the instance of Naege that a delegation was sent. I won against it. Anyway, Woman, on my return from Oduguama yesterday, I invited Mauro Oke and Chidoke and warned them seriously because when a child not of age wears an adult dress, what happens when a strong wind blows? Is it not tragedy? Omona, is it not tragedy? It is not in our best interest to disturb the existing relationship between two people. It is not,
though. You are being so complacent that one begins to wonder. I don't even know.
Say whatever you like, Okachi. Say whatever you like. We all know what investors. But let Una tell us the action he contemplates. But let me caution that he should not use this opportunity to cause disaffection in Azumi or allow some disgruntled elements like in what to call no, 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 no.
Tell your mother that your father is too busy. The survival and dignity of people prevails over those of the individual.
Mine are equally important.
Come back here. Are
you allowing that man to go?
He says it is important.
More important than why you are gathered here?
Well, at least we can carry on peacefully without him.
How can you demand it in the middle of so many men who are useless to it? Men living for themselves.
If they don't expect others to sustain them and die for them.
All this clandestine and doubtful death. Are we sure Nani Uche was his father? Are we sure?
Something has to go. Something has to go.
I can put a KK in his rightful place. But I am guarding against the vision in this struggle. If I strike him now, his bull will shout persecution and collaborate with the enemy. You all witnessed what happened the last time. And your illness has made me.
That is none of your business.
You will have to bring the balance to me tomorrow. The young man will have to go to a uncle to summon you. Go. You don't do things that will make this boy think poorly of you.
I am prepared to deal with any of them who thinks that the attainment of the age of puberty gives one the right to insult his elders. I will die.
What?
They are fighting the matters.
Who?
The people of Obama and our people.
Yeah.
brought to you the lifeless body of my daughter. Take her. You give birth to yours and you give them out in marriage. And I get it. Your decisions have brought woe to my heart.
Oppression and exploitation in my just homes. But you, King
king of Obama, diffuser and destroyer of dragons. You are the vessel in your ambition to want to impose a rule on the peaceful people of Budapest and inherit us. Your master has not understood the terror on us. King Berefule, King Pebble, and others were not oppressors.
Your father did not threaten their survival.
By denying us our rights, I'm to threaten our own existence.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I have no cause to plead. I'd rather die standing for justice than please. Kneeling before an oppressor like me. But isn't it funny to watch one? That carriers of knives need to see others carrying knives behind them. You ran from Okunama for freedom, but you deny my people their freedom.
Your Majesty, please help us escape from the island prison.
Shoot the guards! Shoot the guards! And make sure those prisoners are captured forever! They are gone! Buddha King will surely fight back.
You are sentenced to death.
Yes.
Take it away!
Yes.
You can pass as many false judgments that you may wish to what you want, but do not forget this.
Wait!
That fate has delivered me to the oppressor's hand. There's no judgment or guilt against me. My fate is like that of a farmer who, having sown his seeds, is visited by prolonged rainfall or sunshine. Only his good seeds shall survive. The word of God, justice, rights, art for my people is like a good seed sown in the bosom of the earth. No amount of drought or rainfall shall destroy me. One day, Jubajuba, they will grow into trees. And if I die for just cause. And while my avengers will hunt you here on earth, I will wait for you in the dark world below. I will to my
God.
I will. Whatever my soul can be for me. Sooner or later, I will to my God.
Goes to them. I would not have achieved this feat without their aid and protection. But Ogogo, did I hear you say congratulations and counsel?
Yes.
And what counsel do you prefer?
Spell to make it this
life. Did I hear you well?
And now, he has been punished by the court for his error of judgment. There's no just cause.
No just cause? Rebellion not to be a crime?
Uh-huh. Who has asked for justice? It will end the land and our strength. Am I in a bar? The demands for rights are human and divine. No comfort can alter them without being here.
Don't forget that I too suffered many injustices.
Perhaps it's natural. But how could it happen when you were blown by the wind of destiny?
So how could it be injustice to him when he is being blown by the storm of fate? Don't I have the right to safeguard this kingdom from the white man who has come to destroy humanity?
Your right is recognized.
How then do I fulfill this divine responsibility if not by going to war with enemies and punishing them accordingly?
Am I in a war? I'll do not get in like this instead. He also stood for justice. So I will live in a war and fight the evil children of Oru from beyond the common white debate. Am I in a war? As you would like others to do to you, do to him. You cannot ask for rights. Why you would deny rights? For justice is received by whosoever gives it. Spare the cost of their curse, and do not precipitate their downfall.
Is that why you should oppose my authority?